Good morning everybody. Today we will see advantages and disadvantages of bilinear transformation and some problems related to the bilinear transformation. Okay, now see that. And coming to the advantages, so these are advantages and some disadvantages are there. So in the using bilinear transformation, so it uses one-to-one mapping. So one-to-one mapping means, suppose in a analog filter transfer function, if there are three poles are there, all these three poles are mapped to their respective corresponding location in the digital domain or digital filter transfer function. So that means for every one pole, equivalent pole will be there in the digital domain. Okay, means in the S plane, if there is a one pole, corresponding pole will be there for the Z plane also. That is what is a one-to-one mapping. So the advantage of this bilinear transformation is it provides a one-to-one mapping from S plane to Z plane. Okay, so that is the first one. And coming to the second, stable continuous systems can be mapped into realizable stable digital filter. So the another advantage is, so if you have a stable analog filter transfer function, that analog filter transfer function you can convert into digital filter transfer function. So both are stable and realizable. Okay, so that is means stable means, suppose see, if you have a analog filter transfer function that is stable in S domain, even if you transform it into Z domain using bilinear transformation, so again it is stable and also realizable. So this stability and realizability characteristics are not changed when you convert from analog filter transfer function to digital filter transfer function. That is another advantage. And no aliasing. The third advantage of the bilinear transformation is aliasing, which means when multiple poles are mapped into single location, then aliasing takes place. Suppose see, if you have a poles in S domain, if you have a pole, suppose it is sigma j omega, if you have a poles on this, like this minus 1, minus 2, like this, if you have a poles in S plane, if you convert this analog filter to digital filter, what happens is these poles are one-to-one mapping will be there. Here you may get here and you may get here, like this. So one-to-one mapping takes place here, and because of this one-to-one mapping there is no aliasing. That is the major advantage of this bilinear transformation. One-to-one mapping means for every pole in the analog domain, means H of S, there will be a corresponding pole in the digital domain in the H of Z. That is why one-to-one mapping. If more, suppose see, if these two poles are three poles, if they are mapped to single location, then aliasing takes place. So bilinear, the advantage of bilinear transformation is it will not provide, or means it will not create any aliasing effect. Aliasing means, when you do aliasing, all the means, alias means different components in one domain, they are mapped to a single point in the another digital domain. So as we know that aliasing creates a duplicate waveforms, corresponding duplicate waveforms. So that is the problem. So all these things, actually that aliasing is present in the impulse invariant method that we have seen already. Okay, in the impulse invariant method, so aliasing takes place because that is not a one-to-one mapping. So it is a many-to-one mapping. Many-to-one. Many poles in S domain are mapped to single location in the Z domain. That is why that is a many-to-one mapping. Here in the bilinear transformation, we transform one-to-one mapping. Okay, that is why. So aliasing also, there is no aliasing takes place in the bilinear transformation method. Okay, now coming to the disadvantages, the mapping is highly non-linear. As we know that the relation is between analog frequency and digital frequency 2 by t tan omega by 2. Okay, this is the relation between analog frequency and digital frequency. So now this is a digital and this is analog frequency component. Now you see, as already we have discussed, for low frequencies the relation is, so omega is equal to 2 by t omega by 2. So therefore for low frequencies omega is equal to, so omega by t and omega digital frequency omega is equal to analog frequency times the sampling interval. Okay, the relation is linear. For low frequencies, the relation is linear from this equation, we can say. But as you increase the frequency, then what happens is we will get a non-linear relation. That is tan omega by 2. So because of that, what happens is mapping is highly non-linear. So therefore, high frequency signals are compressed. If you have any high frequency signal in the analog domain, that analog domain high frequencies are compressed in the digital domain. Okay, that is one of the disadvantages. And next one, the impulse response and phase response of analog filter is not preserved in the digital filter transformation. So the phase response and impulse response, these are not exactly preserved as it is when you convert analog filter transfer function into digital filter transfer function, like H of S into H of Z. Okay, some of the advantages and disadvantages of bilinear transformation method. Okay, now we will see some problems on this bilinear transformation method. These are important problems given in the previous exams. So this problem is given in 2019. So we'll see that. So using bilinear transformation, find H of Z from H of S is equal to 2 by S plus 1 into S plus 2 for t is equal to 1 second. So what is t? This t is sampling interval. Okay, t is sampling interval is given and analog filter transfer function is given. So therefore, analog filter transfer function. Okay, TF means transfer function. That is H of S is equal to 2 by S plus 1 into S plus 2. Okay, such type of problems are useful for you for the exams. Okay, and here the sampling interval is 1 second. Because if you want to convert from analog filter transfer function to digital filter transfer function, so we must sample the signal or sample the this particular analog frequency, analog transfer function. So now our purpose is we have to get H of Z. Okay, this is the problem. We have to solve this. Okay, H of Z. We have to get H of Z. So H of Z means what to do is, first we have the relation in bilinear transformation. We have the relation. So S is equal to 2 by T 1 minus Z inverse divided by 1 plus Z inverse. Okay, so this is the relation between analog domain, digital domain. S is the analog frequency variable, Z is the digital frequency variable. So this is the relation between analog frequency and digital frequency. Here sampling interval is 1. Okay, sampling interval is 1. So therefore it is 2 by T. T is 1 minus Z inverse divided by 1 plus Z inverse. 1 minus Z inverse divided by 1 plus Z inverse. Now what to do is, you substitute this S equation in the given transfer function. So therefore H of Z that is equal to H of S at S is equal to 2 into 1 minus Z inverse divided by 1 plus Z inverse. Okay, so the meaning of this is, in H of S, the analog filter transfer function, you substitute S is equal to 2 into 1 minus Z inverse by 1 plus Z inverse, then you will get the corresponding H of Z. That's the meaning of this. H of Z is equal to H of S at S is equal to 2 into 1 minus Z inverse by 1 plus Z inverse. Now you see this, H of S is equal to 2 divided by S. S means 2 into 1 minus Z inverse divided by 1 plus Z inverse plus 1. Okay, this entire thing is 1 term divided by, and another is S plus 2. S is 2 into 1 minus Z inverse divided by 1 plus Z inverse plus 2. Okay, this one. Now what to do is, So we have to simplify this to get this is h of z, to simplify to get the h of z. Okay, so now to simplify this, what to do is simply we have to take the LCM in the denominator. So what you will get, this 2 into 1 minus z inverse plus this one is 1 plus z inverse divided by 1 plus z inverse. Okay, this one. See, if we take a LCM 1 plus z inverse, so therefore this entire thing becomes, this 2 is common for both the terms. 2 into 1 minus z inverse, and this one here 1 plus z inverse divided by 1 plus z inverse you will get. And for this second term, here also if you take 1 plus z inverse common, means as the denominator factor, so then you will get 1 minus z inverse divided by 1 plus z inverse this side plus 2 into 1 plus z inverse. Okay, this is another term. Now after this, just you multiply this. See, 1 plus z inverse is there here, again 1 plus z inverse is there. Then if it comes to the numerator, then it gets simplified like this. See, 2 into this 1 plus z inverse, 1 plus z inverse is there, that is 1 plus z inverse whole square. It becomes to the numerator, because see, 2 by this entire thing is the denominator. In the denominator, so we have again fraction is there, so the denominator of the denominator is 1 plus z inverse whole square. It comes to the numerator and divided by, so 3 minus z inverse into 4. You will get like this. Okay, 2 minus, so if you simplify this, just by multiplying 2 into 1 minus z inverse plus 1 plus z inverse, like that, if you simplify, just it is a simple manipulation. If you do that, you will get this one. And further, this can be written as, see, 2 1s are and 2 2s are. So therefore, 1 plus z inverse whole square divided by, what you have? So, this is 6 minus 6 minus 6 into 2 z inverse. And if you take here 1 by 6 common, then what you will get, 1 plus z inverse whole square divided by 1 minus 1 by 3 z inverse. Like this you can stop, otherwise further you can proceed to simplify to get 1 by 6 is some, you will get some fraction. In the same way, 1 by 3 is 0.33, like that you will get it. So therefore, this is the required h of z. So the procedure is simply, whenever you will be given the analog filter transfer function, and this sampling interval is also given. Suppose if sampling interval is not given, you will see such type of problem later. Now, so when t is equal to 1 second, then in that case, you will get this. First of all, you find out s. After calculating s, just you substitute that s here, and after substituting the s, and if after simplification, you will get the required digital filter transfer function. Now we will see the second problem on this bilinear transformation. Okay, so you have to write down the problem before going through the discussion. Just write down this problem, right? So the system function of analog filter is given as h of s. This is the analog filter transfer function. Okay, analog filter transfer function. h of x is equal to s plus 0.1 divided by s plus 0.1 whole square plus 16. Uptime h of z. What is this h of z? H of z is the digital filter transfer function. Okay. Now, it is that t is not given directly. Sampling interval is not given directly. So, what is given? It resonates at this omega represents the resonant frequency. It resonates at pi by 2. So, therefore, so it is given. So, pi by 2 is given. Now, we will see the solution for this. Okay. First, what to do is, first you find out, we have to find out, the time period, sampling interval. After calculating the sampling interval, so we have to apply that sampling interval in the standard S representation. Okay. Now, what to do is, we will see that. So, the poles. Poles of the system. Poles of the system. See what? The denominator equation represents pole characteristic equation of the transfer function. So therefore, poles of the system is s plus 0.1 s plus 0.1 whole square plus 16 is equal to 0. Then what you will get is s plus 0.1 means if you take whole square and if you simplify that, s plus 0.1 plus j4, another one is s plus 0.1 minus j4 is equal to 0. Okay, so now this is how you can find out the factors of this equation. So s plus 0.1 whole square means s square plus 0.1 whole square plus 2s into 0.1, like that you will get it. And if you simplify that, you will get, so these two roots. So the first root is s1. Suppose if you take s1, so how to get that? So s plus 0.1 plus j4 is equal to 0. So s is equal to minus 0. Means you will have this one. So one root is s is equal to minus 0.1 plus j4 from this. S2 is equal to minus 0.1 minus j4. Just you can equate it. You will get the required parameters. So therefore, what you can say is, so therefore it is sigma plus j omega. Sigma plus j omega. So actually this is equal, and s is equal to sigma plus j omega. So here also same. So therefore, what is the omega? Omega is equal to, so from that we can say it is 4 radians. Omega is equal to 4 radians per second. Now using this omega, we can calculate the so s value, or we can find out the s value or s. Now see, so s is equal to, what is s? S is equal to 2 by t 1 minus z inverse divided by 1 plus z inverse. This is the s value. And after that, so our purpose is we have to get this t. So the t value is, t is equal to, the formula for t is equal to 2 by omega tan omega by 2. Okay, so this is the formula for time period, if you want to calculate the time period. So because we need to find out the t, and after we have to substitute the t here. So therefore, now see, this is analog frequency, this is analog frequency omega. Now this 2 by 4 tan, so this resonant frequency is given, that is pi by 2 divided by 2, so which is equal to t is equal to, so 1 by 2 tan pi by 4. Okay, tan pi by 4 value is 1, we know that. So therefore t is equal to 1 by 2 into 1, so which is 1 by 2, so 1 by 2 seconds. So therefore the sampling interval is 1 by 2 seconds. We got that 1 by 2 seconds now. So now we have to use that sampling interval in this equation to get the h of z. Now the given transfer function is, see, h of z, we have to find out h of z. So in that h of z, wherever, so here this value is 1 by 2. Just now we got s is equal to, t is equal to 1 by 2. So therefore s becomes 4 into 1 minus z inverse divided by 1 plus z inverse. Just you substitute that, wherever s is there, you substitute that, we will get it. So therefore 4 into 1 minus z inverse divided by 1 plus z inverse plus 0.1 plus 0.1 divided by, so this again s is there, 4 into 1 minus z inverse divided by 1 plus z inverse plus 0.1 whole square as 16. Okay. This is just substituting the s value in the h of z. Wherever s is there, just substitute. Now you take the LCM and you simplify that, and finally we will get that h of z is equal to, so 0.128 z square plus 0.006 z plus 0.122. These things you will get after taking the LCM and simplifying the equation, divided by z square plus 0.0006 z plus 0.975. Okay, so these values are, definitely you have to use calculators, and you will get this digital filter transfer function. Okay, this type of problems you will get in the exams. You prepare it well. Thank you.